Let us understand what is deadheading. Why is it important to do it regularly in your garden so that it can encourage a lot of bloom and can also result in a better health of your plant? Let's get started. This is my rose plant. As you can see, it has a lot of flowers, you know, blooming over here. Now, what is deadheading? Let's say this flower. It is almost done with its life. I can see it's like full bloom. Now it has started, you know, dropping down the flower petals and the color has started fading. So I will simply just get rid of this flower. The reason I will do this is because I don't want my plants to form seeds. Not all of them will form seeds, but some of them will. And the plant should not waste energy to keep them, you know, alive for a longer time. Instead, what the plant can do is, if you have a look here, these buds, they will get that energy to bloom. So more deadheading you do, more and more blooming will be there in your plants. Now, if you have a look at my pink rose or even this purple white rose, they are not done with their life yet. So right now I'm not going to touch them. But the moment I see that they are done, I'll just simply chop them from here, just so that I can encourage more and more buds and blooms in my rose plant. Blooming should be a regular thing in gardening. So what I would encourage is, whenever you visit your garden, just check if there is any, almost done flower, spent flower, I would say, and just get rid of them. You can use these flowers to make compost, or even you can just throw them if you want. What I normally do is I'll just put them in the soil in the ground just so that I can get some compost. So you can visit your garden every single day if you have time, or maybe alternate days, and just check for spent flowers like this. My Portulaca plant, I'll just get rid of these dead flowers. Even in marigolds, you can do that. You can just get rid of them. This will also encourage a lot of new buds. As you can see over here, everywhere there are new buds for this marigold as well. And it will bloom faster and more bloom. I mean, the blooming will be easier for the plant because plant has that energy to invest in the correct place. Now for flowers like vinca, if you have a look, these flowers, they don't need deadheading because if a flower is old, the plant will automatically drop it. Sometimes if you see there are old flowers, you can just touch and it will just come out easily. You can do that as well. So this doesn't need scissors or anything special like that, which you may need in plants like roses and marigolds. Now also, if in plants like coleus, you see that there are flowers forming, which you don't need because coleus is not for flowers, it's for leaves. You can just get rid of those flowers so that the energy is going towards more and more, producing more and more leaves and not getting flowers. I hope you enjoyed this video and understanding about deadheading and the importance of deadheading. I'll see you next time in another video with some other content, and do a lot of gardening, and bye for now.